Yes.
So I have a doubt in one question.
Yes, tell me.
Sir, I will read that question to you. Mendel's law of independent assortment holds good for genes situated on the. There are four options. Option A, non-homologous chromosomes. Option B, homologous chromosomes. Option C, extra nuclear genetic element. And option D, same chromosome. So is the answer non-homologous chromosomes?
Independent, tell me the question again.
Mendel's law of independent assortment holds good for genes situated on the non-homologous chromosomes, homologous chromosomes, extra nuclear genetic element, or same chromosome.
They for independent assortment, they are for homologous chromosomes. Okay.
Homologous chromosomes.
Yeah.
Okay.
So independent assortment basically. So
because I had a doubt between is it homologous or non-homologous. That's why.
Actually, independent assortment is basically the independent assortment is basically proved that if two genes are there, so basically it is more true for non-homologous chromosomes. Okay. For segregation, it is for homologous. Yes. For independent, it is non-homologous chromosomes. Okay. Because all the four genes independently assort of one another each other. So it is for non-homologous. Yes. Independent is a segregation for homologous chromosomes. But that independent assortment is more true for non-homologous chromosomes. Okay.
Okay, sir. Non-homologous.
Thanks. Yeah. And anyone have more? Anyone? Anyone can ask any question?
Explain transcription.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Transcription. Okay. So if you talk about transcription is basically, what is transcription? Transcription is basically, what is transcription? Transcription is production of mRNA from DNA. Production of mRNA from DNA. Transcription is production of mRNA from DNA. So if you see that central dogma, if you see the central dogma, just I want to share my screen. So if you talk about central dogma, what does the central dogma says? Central dogma says, first is replication, that is DNA to DNA, formation of DNA to DNA is replication, then DNA to RNA, messenger RNA, that is DNA to mRNA, this is transcription. So copying of transcription, this is your code, and from mRNA to protein, mRNA to protein formation is your translation. mRNA to protein formation is your translation. This is your transcription, translation. This is your translation. So what happens basically in when another from RNA, from mRNA, then it convert into DNA, that is reverse transcription. This is also one central reverse transcription. Is done by reverse transcriptase enzyme. It is, and this mechanism basically, this where it is found, this mechanism is found in viruses, RNA in viruses. This mechanism is found in viruses. The viruses that contains RNA as a genetic material. The viruses that contains genetic RNA as a genetic material. Like in our RNA as a genetic material, like in our coronavirus, RNA viruses. Okay. Coronavirus, they contain reverse transcriptase enzyme which help in transcription of mRNA. From mRNA, it is DNA, then DNA is formed, then again replication, transcription, and translation. So it is reverse transcriptase. Now, transcription means coding of genetic information from DNA to RNA. So genetic information from DNA to RNA is known as transcription. And RNA is messenger RNA carries information from nucleus to the cytoplasm. mRNA, what does mRNA do? When mRNA carries information from nucleus to cytoplasm, where mRNA is translated into protein with the help of ribosome and endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, where they, so they carry information, that they carry information that can be coded into protein, and we know that three nucleic acid code for amino acid. That is known as genetic code. What is genetic code? Genetic code basically three nucleotide code for a amino acid. This is translation. So transcription is DNA to RNA. Transformation of information from transform. What is transcription? Transcription is basically transformation of information from DNA to RNA. From DNA to mRNA, that is messenger RNA. Okay? So basically, if we talk about this is your DNA. This is DNA. This is your 3' This is 3'. This is your 5'. This is your 5'. This is your 3'. This is 2 strand of DNA. This is your coding strand. This is your coding strand, and this is your template strand. So what is coding strand? That coding strand is that strand, the template of which is required to transfer the template. What is coding strand? Coding strand is that strand of which the template is required for to code for mRNA. That coding strand is that strand of which that of which the information required to code for mRNA. Okay, so here the promoter is going to bind. The promoter here on this 3'5', there is promoter site. There is promoter binding. This is your promoter binding site. Promoter site is that site, binding site, where the RNA polymerase is going to bind. Promoter site is that site where RNA is going to be bind. Okay. So coding strand of which the strand are required to code for, and what is template strand? Template strand or is that strand where RNA is transcribed. Template strand is that strand where RNA is transcribed. RNA is transcribed on template strand. Very important. Template strand is that strand where RNA is transcribed, and coding strand is that strand of which the RNA is consists of. The code of which the RNA is consists of. Like if I say that if DNA contains, if 3' to 5' in, this is A, T, G, C. And this is your 5' to 3'. That is your T, A, C, G. This is your T, A, C, G. So the transcription becomes from here. 5' transcription will begin from here. Transcription, because it is a template strand. The transcription will begin from template strand. Because here is promoter site. Here the RNA polymerase bind, and it will form T. Because in case of RNA, there is no T. So then U, then A, then C and G. And this are RNA. This mRNA is similar to this coding strand, like T, A, G, C. Because T in place of the U. So this is similar to the coding strand. So that is why it is the mRNA is similar to the second strand, that is 5'-3', and that is why it is only coding strand. Because the mRNA is similar to the coding strand, that is why this second strand is not a coding strand, whereas the template strand is that strand which is transcribed into mRNA. So template strand is transcribed into RNA in your mRNA, whereas the template strand, whereas coding strand contains the mRNA contains the same genes, same nucleotide as that of coding strand. Okay, but instead of T there will be U. Instead of T there will be U. So this is clear. So in transcription, promoter site is very important. Promoter site is very important because it is a site where the transcription is going to begin. It is promoter site, the site where transcription is going to begin, and promoter site is located at the 5' end of the coding strand. It is located at the 5' end of the coding strand. The promoter site is located at the 5' end of the coding strand. Promoter site is located at 5' end of the coding strand. Okay, or we can say that it is located at 3' end of the template strand. Or we can say that it is located at the 3' end of the template strand. And it is a site where RNA polymerase is going to bind. It is a site where RNA polymerase is going to bind. Okay, and there is termination site. Termination site is located to the 3' end of the coding strand. So we always define promoter site and terminator site with respect to the coding strand. So it is coding strand, at coding strand, promoter site is located at the 5' end of the coding strand, whereas terminator end is at the 3', it is terminator site. Here, terminator site is the site where the transcription is going to start. Terminator site is that site where transcription is going to stop, and it is located at the 3' end of the coding strand. And it contains, there are three terminator code. There are three termination codons. That is UAG, UGA, UGA and UA. This is the three code. UAG, UGA and UA are the codes, that code that is known as stop codon of termination codon. This is known as stop codon and termination codon, that is located on the 3' end of the 3' end of the coding strand. Also known as downstream. This is your upstream. The 5', it is known as upstream. The 5' end of the coding strand is the upstream, whereas 3' end of the coding strand is known as downstream. Very important. Downstream. So it can be also upstream and downstream. Okay. Clear. Now, what happens? So transcription. So this is clear to you all?
Yes, sir.
Always promoter region and termination region is always considered with respect to the coding strand. And in case of transcription, A is in place of E, there will be U. In place of A, that is your adenine, there is uracil. Then for transcription, there is a special type of molecule required, that is known as, for transcription, there is a special type of molecule is required known as RNA polymerase. These RNA polymerase are known as DNA-dependent RNA polymerase. This is known as DNA-dependent RNA because it binds to DNA. So the RNA polymerase is basically DNA-dependent RNA polymerase. This is DNA-dependent polymerase. They are dependent polymerase. They are RNA polymerase, DNA dependent RNA polymerase, and they are very large complex. They are very large complex, consist of four subunits. RNA polymerase consists of four subunits. What are these subunits? These are two alpha subunits are there, one beta dash and one beta subunit. These are the four subunits. And what are their function? The beta dash subunit and what is beta subunit? What are their function? The alpha subunit is bind to the protein. They are bind to the regulatory protein, which binds to regulatory, means the protein that are required for transcription. The protein which binds to the regulatory protein. What are regulatory protein? the protein that are required for transcription, the protein that required for the transcription. Whereas beta subunit, it bind to the RNA nucleotide. It binds to RNA nucleotide. It binds to RNA nucleotide. RNA nucleotide. It binds to RNA nucleotide. Whereas is beta dash the, sorry, this this sorry sorry. One minute. This is beta dash. This bind to the RNA nucleotide, and beta subunit binds to DNA template. This bind to DNA template. This bind to DNA template. So there are four subunits that are present in the RNA polymerase. RNA polymerase is the main molecule that help in transcription and it binds to a promoter region of the DNA. It is DNA dependent RNA polymerase, and it has large sub complex that is four unit. Four unit are our DNA is two alpha subunit that binds to the regulatory protein that help in the protein that help in transcription. Whereas beta subunit is DNA binds to a DNA template, where beta dash subunit binds to the RNA template, okay, RNA nucleotide. Then there is one more. So one, there is one, five subunit. Then there is alpha subunit, very important. Alpha subunit. Due to this, this is also part of RNA polymerase. And due to this alpha subunit of RNA polymerase, the RNA polymerase is going to recognize the promoter region. Due to alpha subunit, RNA polymerase is going to recognize the promoter region of DNA. RNA polymerase is going to recognize the promoter region. Because if they are not going to recognize the promoter, because promoter region is the binding site of RNA polymerase. The promoter region is the binding part of the RNA polymerase. This is sigma subunit. This sigma subunit is going to bind the promoter region, and when it binds to the promoter region, then this alpha subunit binds to the template, binds to regulatory protein. Then beta subunit binds to DNA template, and beta dash will bind to the newly formed RNA molecule, RNA nucleotide. Okay. Then there is also one rho factor, rho subunit, or rho factor. Rho factor. What is rho factor? Rho factor is the termination, help for termination. It helps in termination of transcription. So these are the very, it helps in termination of transcription. So there are basically five main parts. There are basically five main parts of RNA polymerase, that is two alpha subunit. These are the core protein. These are the core protein. Two alpha and two beta. Beta and beta dash. These are the core protein of the RNA polymerase. Two alpha subunit which binds to the regulatory protein. Beta subunit binds to DNA template, and beta dash binds to the RNA molecule. Then alpha subunit helps recognize the promoter site of the DNA. Then rho factor help in termination of transcription. One of the important, and always transcription becomes from, always transcription is done from 5' into 3'. Transcription is grows from 5' into 3'. Very important. Thus direction for transcription is 5' into 3'. Very important. Okay. Then one of the most important thing that differs from replication, that though no primary in case of replication, primary is needed. No primer is needed in case of transcription. Clear? No primer is needed to in case of transcription. Okay? No primer is needed in case of transcription. Then there are, so this is about RNA polymerase, very important. Then there are different types of RNA polymerase. RNA polymerase 1 is required for transcription of RNA pol 1 is required for synthesis of rRNA. Okay. Then RNA polymerase 2, very important. This is the RNA polymerase that is required for synthesis of mRNA. mRNA, messenger RNA. Due to this RNA polar, we mRNA and hnRNA, heteronuclear RNA. So RNA pulse again help in transcription of mRNA and hnRNA. So this is the main transcription enzyme. This is the main transcription enzyme. Then RNA polar is there. RNA polar is there, and this RNA polar help in synthesis of tRNA. These are help in synthesis of tRNA. So these are different types of RNA that are required for synthesis of different type of RNA. There are different types of RNA pol which is required for synthesis of different type of RNA. That is RNA 1 is required for RNA synthesis, ribosomal RNA synthesis. RNA pol second is required for mRNA and hnRNA synthesis, where RNA pol third is required for tRNA synthesis. Clear? Then up to this point I am clear to you all?
Yes sir.
Yeah. Now the transcription is completed in three steps. Basically three steps. The transcription is completed in three steps. Transcription is completed in three steps. It's complete three steps. Transcription is completed three steps. First is known as initiation. That is initiation of gene transcription. Initiation of gene transcription. Initiation of gene transcription. First, there is transcription is initiated. Then elongation. Second is elongation. Elongation. And third is termination. Third is termination. So three steps are there. Initiation, first step. Second step. And third step. These are three steps in which the transcription is done. So first, initiation of gene transcription. First, we'll talk about initiation of gene transcription. Initiation, first of all, how does the transcription feel? First, the binding of RNA pol is done. Binding of RNA pol. Second, RNA polymerase second is done on the DNA template, that is template strand. Okay. At promoter region. Where binding is done? At promoter region. At promoter region, the DNA RNA polymerase is going to bind, and it is bind with the help of sigma factor. Sigma factor is the factor that recognizes the promoter region of the DNA template. Okay, and in case of eukaryote, there are special sequence. In case of eukaryote, that are special sequence that act as a promoter sequence, that is known as TATA box is a special type of sequence present on the eukaryotic DNA where the RNA pol is going to bind. This is known as TATA box. Okay, so what happens? So if TATA box in case of eukaryote present, these are the promoter sequence, and here the sigma factor is going to bind, and when sigma factor is going to bind, then your beta, then your alpha factor is going to bind, and then when alpha factor is going to bind, then beta factor is also going to bind, and there is formation of transcription complex. At that point, there is formation of transcription complex. So, what are the special initiation transcription is that the promoter is region is recognized by RNA polymerase second. In case of eukaryote, this promoter region is known as TATA box, special sequence, that TATA box is there. And when the sigma factor is going to bind this promoter region, then all the complex, all the protein, regulated protein is going to bind on that area. And there is formation of transcription complex. There is formation of transcription complex. Clear? Up to this point, you are clear? So your gene is, your DNA is initiated for transcription. Now your gene is initiated for transcription. Now, what happens in case of elongation? In case of elongation, after initiation, the sigma factor changes. First step is, when sigma factor is going to recognize only the promoter sequence, it has no role in the elongation. So sigma factor detaches. It detaches from the complex RNA polymerase. It detaches. The first step in the elongation, sigma factor detaches from the core enzyme. That is core enzyme. Core enzyme is core enzyme of our RNA polymerase. Two alpha subunit, one beta and one beta dash. These are the core complex. Okay. Then transcription. So they slide over the template. Now this RNA polymerase is going to slide over the DNA template, and while sliding, they recognize the sequence. They perform two things. What? They provide energy for first. They provide energy. They recognize the sequence. And second is they provide energy for polymerization. Okay. So they provide energy for polymerization. So two things are there. They act. So they recognize the sequence, but they act as substrate. And second, they provide energy for polymerization.
Then, so what is acting as substrate? What is recognizing the substrate?
Substrate means they act nucleotide to the sequence, na? So they act as substrate. Okay, the RNA polymerase act as substrate. So those two functions of the RNA polymerase is there. That they act as substrate and they provide energy for polymerization. Okay. The core enzyme. Function of core enzyme of RNA polymerase. Okay. Then, so like this is your DNA.
So what was the second function?
They provide energy for polymerization. Okay.
Okay.
So for adding of the new nucleotide. So at the region, so where transcription starts, there are three things. One is RNA polymerase is there. There is RNA polymerase, their DNA template, and their newly formed RNA. Three things are there. These three things are present in an area known as transcription bubble. These things. So where transcription is going to start, there is three things. There one is RNA, one is DNA, and your newly formed RNA. Okay, DNA, mRNA, RNA polymerase. Three things are there, and the region where these three things are present are known as replication bubble. They are known as replication bubble. Oh, sorry, transcription bubble, not replication bubble. Transcription bubble. They are known as transcription bubble. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now the RNA polymerase will read the sequence of the DNA template up to this region where it does not encounter with row factor. So it will begin transcription of the DNA template as long as no row factor is encountered. So it will start. So replication bubble shifts from upstream to downstream. So replication bubble is going to shift from upstream of the DNA template. Means 4' 5' end of the coding strand to that of 3' end of the coding strand. So it will start shifting from, and in this process they are going to synthesize or elongate mRNA. Okay, clear? So this is your elongation. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Up to this point you are clear. That last part is termination. Last part is termination. So termination of the transcription is done by when there is row factor. Row factor is there. So when it encounters with the row factor, okay, then the termination of the codon is done. So when the row factor is going to attach to RNA polymerase, when the row factor is going to attach with the RNA polymerase, that is core DNA protein, the core RNA complex, then it's core RNA polymerase, it's going to terminate the transcription. Core RNA polymerase. So row factor attaches to the core RNA polymerase, and the termination. Then the transcription is going to start. Stop. Okay. And the newly synthesized mRNA. the newly synthesized mRNA that is formed in the transcription vehicle is going to detach from that point and gets and fall off from the enzyme and falls off from the enzyme complex. Clear? Okay.
So
clear? Yes.
So that
in the eukaryotes, it is independent of the rho factor, right?
What?
In the eukaryotes, it is independent of the rho factor.
It is independent on the rho factor. No rho factor is also present, but rho factor is the factor that is present in the both prokaryotes and eukaryotes, because this is the part where they are going to detach, because rho factor is encountered on the where there is transcription code, there is stop codon. So it is present in both RNA also and DNA. Oh, it is also present in eukaryote and prokaryote also. Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
Rho factor is the only factor when the transcription going to stop. Okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So now, after transcription, there is processing of RNA. The RNA that is formed is basically.
So this RNA which falls out is called the hnRNA, right?
Yeah, hnRNA. Basically, it is hnRNA. Okay.
After processing, it becomes mRNA.
Yeah. Then after processing, it becomes mRNA. That okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So the RNA that falls on is hnRNA. Then there is processing RNA is done. Okay. So basically, it is hRNA is formed in eukaryotes. There is no hRNA in prokaryotes. Okay. So in case of eukaryotes, there is no processing. The RNA formed is mRNA. Okay. In case of eukaryotes, the RNA formed is mRNA. But in eukaryotes, there is hRNA formation. Okay. So processing is required only in case of eukaryotes, not prokaryotes. Okay. Because eukaryotes contains two types of gene sequence. Eukaryotes contains two types of gene sequence. One is known as intron. One is known as intron, one is known as exon. Can you know what is the intron and exon?
Exons are coding sequences as well as introns.
Exons are coding sequences. This is the only part that is going to code for protein. They are coding part. That is the only part that is going to code for protein, where introns are non-coding part. So they must have to be removed. They must have to be removed from the RNA. That is why. So initially the RNA form is very long RNA. Initially, the RNA form is basically very long RNA, and it contains long RNA. It contains some coding parts and some non-coding part. That this is your intronic part. This is your intronic part. The mRNA 5' to 3' end. This is your intronic part. This is your intronic part, and this is your exonic part. This is your exonic part. So basically, they are removed. These intronic part are removed. Okay, and then removed. This is known as heteronuclear hnRNA. This is known as heteronuclear RNA. Heteronuclear RNA. They are removed by processing, and then the coding part is joined only. Only coding part. One coding part, exonic part, one code. So this is your coding part. Exon part, exon part. They are joined. They are cut and removed, and they are joined. And this is known as exonic part, and this is known as mRNA. Okay, then when mRNA is formed, then next thing, the mRNA, there is further processing then that it is capping. Capping is then. Capping is then. On 5' in capping is then. And capping is done of methylated DNA. There is capping. Methylated guanosine is added to the 5'. Methylated guanosine is added to the 5'. Methylated guanosine is added on the 5', guanosine, and this is known as capping, is added to the 5', this is known as capping, this is known as capping. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And what does the capping do? Capping help in aligning of RNA with ribosome. This capping will help in alignment of mRNA with that of ribosome doing translation with ribosomes doing translation during translation. So they help alignment of RNA with ribosome during translation. Then at 3' end there is polyadenylation. At 3' end there is addition of adenine group. That is known as polyadenylation. Polyadenylation. At 3' end the adding of adenine group at the 3' end, and this is known as polyadenylation. And this signals this tail, and this is known as tail region. This is known as tail region of mRNA, and this signals end of transcription. This signals end of transcription. So in mature RNA, there are three regions. In mature RNA, there is three regions. That is, if you draw mature RNA, there are three types. In case of there's three types. This is for 3' end. This is 5'. This is your at 3' end. There is your at polyadenylation, and at 5' end there is methylation, methylated guanosine. That is no capping. This is cap region. This is structural mRNA. And this is your tail region. Clear? So a structural RNA that contains a structural gene. Okay? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Clear? And on this part, so if you draw a clear structure of mRNA, mRNA look like this. This is single strand. It is like this. This is known as methylated. If you draw, so this is your cap region. Okay, it is present on methylated GTP. Then this is your non-coding region. This and this region is non-coding region. Thus, this is your coding region. This is your start codon. That contains your AUG. Okay. Then this is your structural gene. And this is your stop codon. Where translation going to stop? Stop codon. Okay, and it is present in the 5' end. This is your 3' end. This is your 5' end. And this is your non-coding. And this is your polyadenine tail. This is the mature gene. Okay, mRNA. This is mature mRNA. Clear? Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
So, processing of RNA involves what are the different things that are involved in processing? Processing of RNA is capping. Capping is done at 3' end. Then
splicing.
Tailing. Tailing is addition of polyadenyl group. Then your splicing. Splicing means splicing, cutting and removal. Splicing. Okay, introns. Splicing is done. Then your ligation, of the cut part, then it is joining, and then your fully
so the ligation is done by DNA ligation.
Clear? So I am clear up to this part.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
How much time do I have left for the class?
Four minutes.
So it is clear to you all. If any doubt is there, transcription is clear to you?
Yes, sir. Transcription is clear.
Okay. So if I draw a diagram, just quick revision. If I draw a diagram, this is how transcription is going to do. This is your DNA. This is your 3' end. This is your 5' end. So then the rho factor is going to bind, the sigma factor is going to bind this point. Okay, sigma factor, then RNA polymerase is going to bind on this point. Okay, oligomer polymerase, then sigma factor, then it is initiation. Then your transcription going to initiate on this. There is a formation of replication bubble. There is formation of replication bubble. Okay, and replication bubble, there is sigma factor detaches. Then this is your rho. Then it helps in synthesis of RNA. Then elongation, and then this is your elongation. This is your elongation. Then when at last there will be termination. At last there will be termination. So at last there will be there is rho factor going to attach. Then rho factor is going to attach to the RNA complex. Rho factor is going to attach. Okay. Then this RNA is removed from this. This is termination. So this is how whole replication is done. Whole replication. Whole transcription is done. Okay. This is your initiation step. This is your initiation. This is your elongation. And this is your termination. This is your termination. Clear? Clear, student? Okay? Clear? Everyone?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do you?
Sir,
do you
I have want... a doubt and an assertion reason question. Can I ask that now?
Yeah, yeah. Nah. Any doubt you can ask. Okay? Yeah.
So the assertion is mRNA has some untranslated regions that are not translated. Recent yeah. UTRs are required for efficient translation. Options yeah. are option A, assertion is assertion, both assertion and reason are true, and assertion is the correct explanation. Sorry, reason is the correct explanation of the assertion. Option B is both assertion and reason are true, but reason yeah. is not the correct explanation of the assertion. So, sir, which one is
again? Repeat the question.
Yeah. Assertion is mRNA has some untranslated regions that are not translated.
Yeah.
Then reason is UTRs, that is untranslated regions, are required for efficient translation.
And?
Yeah, that's the question. Then options are both A, option A, both assertion and reason are true, and reason is the correct explanation of the assertion. And option yes. B is both assertion and reason are true, but reason is not the correct explanation of the assertion. Option C is assertion is true, reason is false. Option four is D is both assertion and reason.
Assertion is correct and reason also correct. Okay.
Yeah. So reason is the correct explanation of the assertion, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I had a doubt in that. I thought. Yeah. I had doubt in option A.
Okay. So. I think so if you have any question, any doubt in the question also, you can also message me, text me, okay, before examination also. When is going